I have to go, assume, to a place where there are all foolish men. How can I maintain my individuality? First of all, the individual does not have to go anywhere. Have to implies compulsion. Have to implies that there is somebody else who is your master. If he goes somewhere, it would be out of his own understanding. He would fully understand why he is going somewhere. And I mean, how can you say that there are foolish men somewhere unless you yourself have understood that they are foolish? This understanding that others are foolish can come only from your own intelligence. Isn't it possible that you are already with those foolish men, but you cannot see that they are foolish? Isn't it possible that you are already surrounded with foolish men, but you cannot see that they are foolish? How can you see that? When you have not opened your eyes, how is it possible to see that? Suppose six men are sleeping in a room. Is it possible for one of the sleeping men to know that the other five are sleeping? If six men are sleeping, is it possible for one of them to know that other five are sleeping? Thus, a sleeping man cannot know that the others are sleeping. Similarly, a foolish man can never know that the others are foolish. To know that the others are sleeping, you must first be awake. Am I right? When you wake up, then you can say, alright, these five are sleeping. To know that the others are sleeping, you must first be awake. And hence, to know that the others are foolish, you must first be intelligent. How do you know that others are foolish? How do you know? You have attached labels to people, and all those labels are coming from your past. You have attached adjectives to people and you do not know where those adjectives come from. But you are using those adjectives to classify people. Your very relationship with others is based on those adjectives. You call somebody intelligent because he gets good marks. And then you develop a particular relationship with him because you think he is intelligent. Now this definition of intelligence itself is a stupid definition. Your very relationship, the very foundation of your life is based on labels that you are giving to people. Foolish is one of those labels. You call certain people foolish, but you don't even know why you are calling them foolish. Because to call somebody foolish, first of all, you have to be intelligent. When you call somebody anything, then you do that just because others have been calling him this or that. Are you getting it? Once you know out of your own understanding, then you will also know the right action that must be done. Then you don't have to ask. Then you don't really have to ask. Before you attach labels to people, see where those labels are coming from. And you do not know a person without a label, right? You have labeled some people as friends, you have labeled somebody else as enemy, you have labeled somebody as boring. And there are thousands of labels that you have attached to people. Labels of caste, labels of religion, labels of gender, labels of economic status. And using these labels, you are dealing with the world. Foolish is another such label. Why attach labels? First of all, wake up and find out what is the reality. Yes? The mind of the child is like a sponge. It is influenced by everything. Everything. Just as a sponge absorbs everything it comes in contact with, that's how a child's mind is. It's like a clean slate. Anything can be written about it. Have you seen children, how curious they are? How they want to look at everything? Have you ever seen a child on the back seat of a car? He would sit with his face towards the rear windshield. And he would be looking all around. And he's absorbing and absorbing and absorbing. And absorbing. And that is inevitable. Nothing wrong with it. Because the child is not born with information. It is alright that he must collect all information from the outside. He will do that. Along with the information also come beliefs and influences. The child absorbs not only what he sees, but also a particular religion. He is made to absorb it. He is also made to absorb a lot of beliefs about what the world is like. The neighbor is bad, uncle is good. And such things. And he cannot resist it. There is no way he can resist it. It is not possible for him. He is utterly helpless and dependent. Agreed? And it's alright that he is told all these things. He must be told which side of the road to walk. He must be told that the water is hot and you should not put your hand in it. His brain is not yet adequately developed. Just like a sponge, it is absorbing and absorbing and growing. But are you a child? Are you a child? Are you still 5 years, 8 years, 10 years old? Why must this thing keep happening with you? The child is dependent, it is understandable. The child is helpless, it is understandable. But at your age, why are you still mentally like that child? Why can't you look at the world with your own eyes, with your own understanding? The child cannot do that. It's a physical disability. His brain is not developed. The whole neurological system is not developed. But you are very developed. Why must you spend life like a child? Dependent, holding, clutching, grasping. Why?